Hello everyone and welcome to this presentation. We are Steven Costiot, Alain Plantec, Eric Leporce, and me, Pierre Laborde. We present 15 years of reuse experience in evolutionary prototyping for the defense industry. The applications that are developed for the defense industry at Thales are made of very rich graphical features and advanced interaction mechanisms. The development of these applications involves many three teams, from the early design to the deployment. System definition engineering teams build high-level component systems according to requirements, then the prototyping teams develop prototypes that are fully functional applications with very rich graphical features and advanced interaction mechanisms. The software engineering team develops the final product. The three teams need to communicate and share the same vocabulary, requirements, concepts, and their operational semantic. Components and component-oriented programming help us to fulfill this need, and traditionally, components are used throughout the entire lifecycle of a product. Our prototypes are fully functional applications that are used to evaluate users' requirements through realistic scenarios. Thus, they also need to implement very rich graphical features and advanced interaction mechanisms. The usability of a prototype is fundamental to involve the customer. This implies a nearly and strong feedback loops between users and designers. As an example, the two applications that are presented here manage geographic views and interactions on different kinds of objects that are represented on our cartographic background. The underlying geographic subsystem is fully reused by the two applications. In fact, each application uses and defines its own configuration of the same set of components. Another point is that prototyping allows us to take advantage to anticipate needs and potential architecture problems before the implementation of the final solution. Finally, such a prototype helps us for the evaluation of the final cost of the product. Thus, prototyping is a very time-consuming activity and reuse is a practice to reduce the development cost. After 15 years of prototyping, we noticed that the use of the component paradigm helped us for our reuse practice. To fulfill our need, we have developed a specific component framework called Molecule. We have presented our prototyping practice at Thales. The remainder of this presentation is organized as follows. We present the use of the component approach in building prototypes through the use of Molecule, our component framework. After, we present the different levels of reuse that the component approach allows at Thales. And we briefly present some technical aspects of Molecule. Then we present the benefits that we have identified after 15 years of reuse and the difficulties that we encountered. Finally, we conclude with some perspectives. Now we describe Molecule. Molecule is presented as a component framework for live prototyping in Faro. Molecule is based on lightweight CORBA component model, a standard architecture used for industrialization. It allows for the specification of components as in the CORBA standards, provided on used services, produced on consumed event. This figure shows typical Molecule components presented according to the CORBA description. It exhibits the use and produces services, the consumed and produced events. Additionally, in our implementation, we had the concept of use and provided parameters, which are mainly used for the initialization of components. At the application level, a system is made of a set of components interconnected through services, events, and parameters. As an example, this figure shows the provided services that are connected to the uses services of users' components. Being able to build reusable and homogeneous software architectures was the first motivation for using components. Our components can be reused without any change by several prototypes. This kind of reuse is now possible because we capitalized a sufficient quantity of components. After a decade, we benefit from a virtuous circle where a finished prototype is kept in a prototype repository and some of its components set can be reused later from another prototype. This virtuous circle tends to minimize the number of prototypes that we need to implement from scratch. From previous legacy code, We build standardized and reusable components defined by their contracts. When a component assembly covers a technical or business requirement, it becomes a subsystem, for example, a geographic view with layering, filtering, selection, etc. Prototypes reuse and deploy instances of subsystems and of single components. Each time we build a new prototype, we identify new functionalities of reusable bricks and we integrate them back into the repository or existing components or subsystems for the future reuse. Change and evolution of software is always an issue. Switching to another technology implies modifying the existing software code to integrate that technology. This kind of change hinders our ability to reuse software to evolve our prototypes. For example, graphical user interface technologies, GUI, are often changed. Because they evolve, they become obsolete and they stop being maintained. A new GUI framework will expose different interfaces and trigger different events. This forces developers to rewrite the same GUI in different technologies over the years. Regarding GUI, as another example of evolution, we often interact lively in the front of customers during presentation of a product. During such a presentation, hot updates can be done to directly take into account customer remarks and requirements. This kind of update is particularly made easier thanks to components because of the contracts which stay stable. Because our prototypes are composed of components, in case of such a change, only a well-identified part of the system has to be adapted. We evolve the related components implementation without changing GUI clients nor legacy and business software. Our prototypes are implemented with Faro. Faro is a pure object-oriented programming environment inspired by the Smalltalk language and which is class instance-based. Basically, a molecule component is a class which inherits from Mol Abstract Component Imp class. A particular component class is related to the definition of the component interface. Such interface is implemented with a thread. A thread is defined as a reusable unit of behavior. A thread is defined by a name and it specifies a set of methods, signature plus an optional behavior. The reuse of a thread by a class is specified in the class definition with the thread name. A class that uses a thread can directly reuse the thread methods or can redefine their behavior locally. In Molecule, a component is designed as a set of interconnected threads. The component interfaces related to the services, the events, and the parameters are all designed as separated threads. Services, events, and parameters, threads, specify the interfaces that the components implement. All these component interfaces are declared through the component type, which represents the business contract. The business contract is made of an aggregation of services threads, event threads, and parameter threads. In the type, these threads are declared according to the categories of the contract: used services, provided services, consumed event, produced event, used parameters, and provided parameters. A component is itself a class that uses a particular component type thread. A component which uses a type thread must implement interfaces that are specified in each category of the business contract. In summary, in Molecule, threads are used as interfaces definitions, and a component class that uses a particular type thread specifies the implementation code. As a consequence, is it possible to have several different implementations of the same contract? As an example, the Mol component services contains the method called an interface. This interface is a provided services in the Mol component type. A component that uses this Mol component type will have to implement the an interface method. This use of threads have several advantages. First, threads allow us to benefit from a kind of static design for the specification of contracts. Second, threads facilitate the reuse of component contracts parts. Third, threads facilitate the integration of existing classes into a component. we have been building our reuse processes, frameworks and tools during these last 15 years. In the following, we reflect on the strengths and weaknesses of reuse in our prototyping activity. We observe that among these last 15 years of prototyping, we apply systematic reuse the most in three scenarios. These scenarios are first, long-term reuse of legacy code, second, reuse of non-component framework, and third, reuse of component business interfaces. Let's explain the scenarios a bit more in detail. The most common scenario of reuse that we encountered is the systematic reuse of components from prototype to prototype over the years. When we begin a new prototype, we always reuse parts of previous prototypes. With time, some components form complete subsystems that encapsulate a particular functional requirement and that are entirely reusable. For instance, the tactical view is a subsystem that we built 10 years ago. The tactical view displays geographical business objects on a cartographic background. We maintain and reuse the tactical view subsystem in a lot of prototypes since then. The look and feel can be configured differently depending on the requirement of each prototype. As an example, several cartographic projections can be reused or a new one can be added. The second case of reuse that we encounter is the reuse of non-component frameworks or legacy code. We frequently need to support pre-existing frameworks as well as emerging frameworks, typically new graphics engines and backends, but they are often no component-based and use standard object-oriented classes. Using Molecule, thanks to the threats mechanism, we can extend these classes with component behavior, and we can reuse the graphics engine features and objects seamlessly into our architectures. Imagine that we want to reuse a particular graphic element which is not available as a component. With Molecule, this graphic element class can be turned as a component class and directly reused in the application. This is typically the case of open source graphics engine that we reuse in our prototypes. The third case of reuse that we encounter comes from the reusability of component contracts. Component contracts express interactions between components. The direct benefit is that we can interchange any components with other exposing the same contracts. For example, imagine that we need to migrate a database application to a new database backend. Database requests are implemented in a component. Data request, for example, get me the username John Doe, is defined in a component type threads. Other components communicate with the database through the contract defined by the type to request data without knowing about the database access details. To change the database backend, a new component is implemented. This new component reuses the type tray for high-level data access. Then we can transparently replace the old component by the new one in the prototype. The story of Prototype X is a successful illustration of the application of these scenarios. For confidentiality reasons, we cannot reveal its name. This example is representative of a fast real-time prototype we built and that we evolved during the years. This prototype is a multi-user user interface for touch tables that we built in 2019. At the time, we did not have code implementation touch table ergonomics with multiple users at the same time. But we had most of the business and tooling behavior already implemented in existing components in our repository. We rewrote 22 new components and 35 new classes. And we directly reused around 600 components and 1,000 classes from 5 existing subsystems. We do not count as reuse framework and tool code that we need in all our prototypes. Overall, the complete prototype is composed of 674 components plus 1,700 additional classes for about 50,000 methods, including framework code. Reused components represent 89.47% of the prototype's components and reused classes. The example of prototype X that we just saw is a typical example of successful massive reuse in our prototyping activity. It looks awesome, but in reality we struggle with difficulties. We do not rigorously know when to create a throwaway component or a reusable one. Making a component reusable has a high cost if we do not reuse it after. We need means to identify when a component will be reused. We also like rigorous means of evaluating components and subsystems to choose for reuse. Live exploration with Faro has its powers. But today, we have too much components and we cannot explore everything. We certainly sometimes miss reuse opportunities because of that. Or we lose time by reusing inadequate components. Efficient reuse requires extensive knowledge of existing components. Unfortunately, for now, our component repository is not documented well enough. The example of prototype X required an expert to know what subsystem could be reused. Today, our experts are the ones knowing the reuse possibilities of the components and subsystems we accumulated over the years. When the experts leave, we lose the knowledge. Managing and reusing existing components is complex. It requires deep technical, domain and business understanding and needs to be shared from experts to beginners. This is one important research question now for us, that is, how to transfer efficiently that knowledge to new team members. Subsystems are sometimes too focused on realizing business behavior. Business behavior blends with technical behavior, and we cannot reuse part of the subsystem without reusing it entirely. It leads to inappropriate reuse of business and technical features. We need to reflect on this to find how to design components and subsystems in a way that their features are atomically reusable. As a conclusion, at Thales, we evolve and maintain many prototypes for years. Since 15 years, we developed reusable components using Smalltalk, and we reuse these components in our prototypes. Today, we capitalize this experience in Molecule, a component framework built in Faro Smalltalk. We presented our reuse scenarios, long-term reuse of legacy code, reuse of non-component frameworks, and reuse of component business interfaces. We also reported our reuse difficulties, what to reuse, how to know when invest in building reusable components, how to find out if existing components can fulfill software requirements. To improve how we select reusable elements, we plan to study how to exploit preliminary system models to allow for the early identification of reusable elements. We also plan to conduct larger scale empirical studies at Thales to better understand how we applied reuse over the years. This will help us to take a step back and to reflect more on our reuse processes in order to improve our prototyping activity and to standardize our reuse practice. Please note that the Molecule is fully available on GitHub. Thank you a lot for watching this presentation. Don't hesitate to provide us with feedbacks.